Want to give a shout out to the Twitter user Sorajit Dutta for bringing this to my attention. Give him a follow. So Sorajit here actually tags me in a quote tweet that showcases something rather interesting from the Twitter user Honey Dewan. So Honey Dewan tweets out, tagging Team YouTube, YouTube India, and Shogun Kugan comic with the following: recently received several copyright strikes on my Pokemon manga videos, which has in turn given me more than 3 strikes. My channel will be terminated in 7 days. I have realized that it was not right to make videos about the Pokemon manga. They continue on with, but channel termination is too big of a price to pay. I've worked on this channel for years, and losing it because of a wrong choice I made would break me. Please find a place in your hearts to forgive me, as this is my main source of income, and I totally depend on this channel. And if we actually check out this individual's channel, they go by the name Pokevenger, with over 443,000 subscribers. That is a sizable channel, my friend. Now, taking a look at this individual's content, we can see that there is a lot of Pokemon anime-related content, and it seems to be based on discussions. Now, this is unfortunately in a different language that I can't understand. So that right there is at least my impression when I take a look at their channel. And last I checked, discussions fell under fair use. Now, what exactly is fair use? Well, in the most general sense, a fair use is any copying of copyrighted material done for a limited and transformative purpose, such as to comment upon, criticize, or parody a copyrighted work. Such uses can be done without permission from the copyright owner. In other words, fair use is a defense against a claim of copyright infringement. If your use qualifies as a fair use, then it would not be considered an infringement. And if we especially highlight this part right here, comment upon, that sounds a lot like discussion slash criticism, which is in turn something that this individual has done based on my observations of this person's content. So as far as my analysis goes, seems like this individual is falling pretty well within the lines of fair use. Now, I'm making this video on July 19th, and this issue cropped up on July 17th, so it's been a couple of days since we have had any updates in regards to this situation, and the last time that this individual had tweeted was, in fact, on July 17th, so I'm not sure if the situation either resolved itself or if it's still ongoing, but all I can do is spread awareness and hope for the best for this individual, and I will keep you guys in the loop should there be any updates that take place in this situation. Thank you guys all very much for watching. Also, what you're seeing is my Twitter page. If you want to follow me on Twitter, then the link to that will be in the description down below. Thank you guys very much for watching. Thank you for your time. Have yourself a damn good one, and I'll see you guys in the next video.